Good morning. This is Dr. Bill Wyatt again with the American Orthodontic Society, and I want to talk to you this morning about a deep bite case, but it has several other problems. I think there are five or six or maybe seven other problems we'll try to bring out in this, and one of them especially is the last part of it is retention of this type of case. These cases will fool you if the person leaves the retainer out for a week or something and the bite deepens a little more and they put it back in their mouth, then they close together and the bite is deepened so it only touches up here in the anterior part and back in the condyles. We'll discuss that. That's something that fools a lot of people. Fooled me for a while, and we kind of figured that out. So let's get started with this young man. He's a very nice guy, and but he's got a terrific deep bite case here. And let me touch this and see if we can get this to go. Looking at it straight on, you don't notice this too much. The young man came to me with his bicuspids extracted, and the case just kind of must have deepened, and you can't hardly see, I don't believe you can even see his permanent teeth here, the permanent lower teeth are underneath here, and they'll be right up here close to the roof of the mouth on the inside, and the teeth extracted back in this area, and one side is class one, the other side is nearly class one, but it's about half class two in the posterior, but the anterior part is class two, division two, this whole anterior portion out here. And on this side, I believe we're almost correct, back here it's about halfway class two. Let's take another look at it. A little closer up here, and let's see. Now these teeth look fine right here. See, that's the class, the molar position and the first bicuspid are right where they ought to be. But then this tooth is back here, and so these teeth in here, these lower teeth are in a class two relationship. So we're going to have to correct that. Now these teeth were out when the young man came to me, as best I remember. And so we picked the case up and try to correct this problem. All right, we'll go ahead and look at the other side. Now this is not as solid class one as the other, but not really class two. In this part of the mouth, you see this molar should be on out here a little further, but it's not bad. And this bicuspid should be this point on the coming down in this groove right here. Now the teeth that are missing are the first bites right in this area right here. And so to correct this, we're going to have to get in and elevate. And the torque on these teeth is way back here, and it should be out something like that. So we're going to have to torque these and raise them out, and then we'll move these teeth back, and these teeth will come forward some of the way to fill that in. So we'll go ahead and get started on that. All right, we've got this gap now between the second bicuspid and the cuspid right in here, and we're going to have to let these teeth drop down further, and these teeth are still pretty good relationship with the lower arch right there. And now we'll go on to the next slide on the lower. These lower teeth have erupted up, and they're up underneath the back of the upper teeth. I don't think I've got a picture showing that, but anyway, you can visualize these teeth are really high and actually touching the gum tissue behind. And so we'll have to lower them and change the torque on them to fix this portion down here. Let's go. Now, this was done in 1973 or 4, something like that, before we got the brackets going. So we just used bands on this case. And here, rather than the single band, we used a double band, so that reduced the amount of inner bracket space we got. But in here, the change this arch part. But these are intruding arches. They're on there. Let's piggyback over another arch part. So you don't see the other arch part you get here. You'll see it. We'll show it further and we get to this deal here. Now we put a segmented arch back here and just left it and cut the arch. And I don't really like to do that, but anyway, you can come in and just run a flexible wire like that. And now this is your intruding wire. It's an excellent example of it. The tube for the intruding wire is here. The tube for the arch wire is right here. And on this spring, coming out of that tube, you just kind of make a circle like this. And now you just carry this on around and you bring this down and hook it. So this is the wire that would be around here. And now we brought it down. And so it's picking these teeth up. The teeth were sitting at a kind of a tucked in angle, but you're out in front of them and the root goes up something like that, and as this tooth comes up it tends to torque out right here. That's when these teeth will actually move forward. As they do, you tie them onto this back here so they drag the other teeth out with them. This is a good example of a round intruding arch mark. You can move them out of rectangular if you like. And we'll go to, now looking at it from the front, you've got an intruding wire right here. It would be down in this area. We come up and hook it to this. And you can start this intruding wire, and we just did this in sections right here. So this raises up, and this wire here will actually go back through that tube right there. Now, the force that's going to carry these anterior teeth, the laterals, the cuspids hardly move at all, but it comes from these bicuspids, the second bi and the first molar on the person. Now this guy is not chewing as hard as some. And we've got this on and we've already come up a good bit with this. Let's go ahead now and look on the other side. We've got the lower intruding wire, which we hear. So it's pulling them down in this direction. These are going up in this direction. These lower anterior teeth to make these teeth go down, they've got to be forced up. And these to make these go up in this direction, these teeth are going to have to try to go down. So you're going to increase the vertical dimension of the face. In a case like this, whenever this goes down and this goes up, whenever you add on to it, it's going to increase the vertical dimension of the facial structure in there. So you want to keep that down to a very minimum And so you have to make sure this guy's going to chew on this. And this one, the wire being cut here, is going to let that move a good bit. Now we look at it from the, just the palatal side, the lower interior hitting right up in here, underneath that. And everything else is lined up very good there. Now on the bottom arch, we use a, back then, I used a lingual arch. You come in here and you go down, run this around this way, and back into your motor. But we found out you don't really have to have that intruding, this lingual arch in here. You can do this perfectly fine with just your regular arch wire in the slot, and then your intruding wire on top of that, and you don't have to put this in there. So that's something that you don't have to do in today's work. Now here we're on these teeth, we're out in front of them, and as we're going up with them in this direction, just remember the tooth was kind of set back something like this. And the roots of the teeth were going on up in here. And but you're out here. So when you push this up, this tooth is going to tend to go forward. And that's exactly what happens in this particular case. It'll happen to nearly any of them. Find the same thing on the lower end here. Here's a close-up of the intruding wires. If you haven't used them, this is the most efficient way to level the bite. You start leveling it the day one. And so in this one, we cut the arch wire here, but I don't do that anymore. I just take a flexible wire going up there, kind of like we're doing back here on this area. And we take the intruding wire, which goes way down here, bring it up, is a piggyback over this flexible wire. This one is piggyback over that other wire underneath there. Sorry, my voice is pretty poor today, but maybe you can understand what I'm talking about. So here are the intruding wires on the other side of the mouth, leveling that out. Now here we go, after a few months of treatment, this is 1177, and I forget just when we started it. And then we still got the intruding wires on the case, but we've opened up to this point right here. And so it's picking these teeth up, and they're also moving. The crowns are coming forward, kind of like they're not, they were there like this, and they kind of do that as they go up. And then you have to drag this behind, keep this right in here, and you fill the facial structure out some doing this. Now, we're partway almost finished as far as opening the bite. Now we're going up with these teeth, and you'll notice the torque is quite different. They work when the teeth were back like that. Now they're out in this fashion. And when you pick them up, they go up down like that. Now you get them up there, you're going to close this space. You get it where the lower interiors are not hitting the backs of these upper interior teeth. And so here we are on the lower arch. We're still using this lingual arch. This comes over here and goes down, down, down. And it's all right to do that, but you really don't need the lingual arch in doing this. You can do it without it, and you can just do the two arch wires out here, and that's all you really have to have. Alright, there's a close-up of the intruding arch. Let's see this spray. This arch was going out like that. Now they put it down here. So it's picking these anterior teeth up in this direction, but it's also pushing this down. Now you intend for the person to chew on this quite a bit, and on this, he did not chew this hard enough. But you remember those two wires, we had it cut in here, and as it brought these up, this wire came right in line with this other one. I don't have to do that. We just start off with a flexible wire. Now, after doing this for a while, these two teeth, he did not chew on hard enough, and so they moved down and back. This wire right here was pretty stout, pushing that, and it moved these teeth down, and they also backed them up. Now we go back. Now that's the way it was when we put it in, and this moved back here. So this theory of the occlusion on your six-year molar, it's working, but he doesn't chew hard enough. On a case like that, you can go in back when you're like this and line up, and you can bond another acrylic block on there and have a bite on it and cut it over. They'll chew good, and that makes them chew harder over here, and these teeth do not come down like they've done here. And here they came down and back like that. They're pressing them down and back. So we have to correct that now. So we continue to work with it. It's 1978. And we've got him lined up pretty good now. The intruding wire is still on the upper. And I don't think we have it on the bottom yet. And on the upper, it's continue to do that. So we get this up, and we're going to close this space. We'll bring this up from there. Now the bottom, we just have a little bit of space right here. We're going to pull that together, and we've got that lined up pretty good. Now this is 1978, and we're almost finished with this case. Still got the intruding wire over there, and these are the midlines on here, and I think our space is closed up pretty good. We're still using the intruding wire. Okay, the space is not completely closed up there, so we've still got some work to do. So we open the bite a little more, and now we'll continue to close the space. And this is about as far as we've gone in the case. But here's where the teeth were to start here. And now there's where we ended up in 1979 with this case. The midline is off a little bit, but there's some sizing of the teeth probably threw it off to some extent. Now I'll take that back. The cusp, you see, is not fitting in here as good as it is on this side. So this is shifting in this direction a fair amount. Now, we had bands on this tooth, these teeth, and we had to close on. You've got two sheets of metal and two layers of cement between every tooth. And we've got to close those spaces, and you want the case, so you have to torque the teeth more than you want. And when you get the case together like this, it'll take away some of the torque, but you have to close the space to finish. And that was a touchy thing to do. But we had a rubber band from here going through this little pad here, and we'll wear that and chew bubble gum and close the space up that way. I think they've been wanting to chew the bubble gum anyway. And here is a gap that we had to start with, and here it is when we finish. We left these bands on. We'll take them off and close this space with an extension. And here is the upper. You see the angle on it. These are sitting out here. Now I can't see these at this same angle, but they're just straightened out more like that back to this division. The midline looks like it's better, and the teeth here looks again to a good spot in there. So the gap in the upper arch is out of the cuspid, and now that's closed together. And we've got all that fitting in, and we'll take this off in our retention. And of course, if we use these, leave these on for a while, and we pull that up in case it tends to open up a little, and then you take your upper six of bands off. And here it is, 1979, and we're in a good class one relationship. Back in this area, the midline is just about where we want it. And there's our retainer in the case, and we'll take these bands out. And I think I won't have the pictures on them at that point. Now that looks pretty good. That's when we finished up the case and put the retainer in there. Now, on any closed back case, I don't care who they are, if you open this up and intrude the upper anterior teeth and you have a gap in here, you may have increased the height of the lower posterior, and you'll increase the height of the face. The face tends to go back, and it tends to deepen after you get through. So your lower anterior teeth are going to fit right in here. And if you take this retainer out, it's got this black plate, and you leave it out a week or 10 days, and you put it back in, the lower anterior teeth will move up more. So when you stick it back in, they hit right up here, and nothing else hits except contact of the joint, and you'll chew on that, and it puts the force here and on the joint rather than the bone structure in here, and that will cause these joints to start hurting and feeling bad, and the person will think the retainer is not fitting properly, where the retainer is fine. If you stick with it, the pain will go away, and these anterior teeth will be opened again, and you'll fit in there right. But some people just take the retainer out, but it quits hurting. Well, because you, now your teeth are touching further up in the arch here. This is a trick that fools most people who finish deep bite cases. They don't realize if they take the retainer out, the teeth will deepen some more, and then when they close together, if they put the retainer back after 10 days or more, it will hit it here, and then nothing but the joints hit. And you start chewing on these front teeth, and you start having a discomfort in here, and so you take the retainer out, and the discomfort goes away because now the teeth went from here and it would fit the right. But you leave it out a while, the lower anterior teeth will deepen something like this. Now I put the retainer back in and I close together. I've got a gap in here that wide, and now when that touches, nothing hits but the molar. Your back teeth don't come in contact, so you're not biting teeth against teeth and bone against bone. It's the joint and the anterior teeth. And that fooled me for a good while till I finally ran that down and figured out exactly why it was hurting. There was nothing in the world wrong with the retainer. So to go back on somebody with tender joints, you had to put some pads back here and let the teeth come together, but use the pads to take the force up in this area. Voice is bad today. I'm sorry. And here's the young man after we finished. And I think that's all that I've got. And the main thing I want to learn, you learn, is watch out for attention here. If you leave this thing out, then these lower anterior teeth are going to go on up further. These will drop down some. And when you close together, it'll hit first here and then back on the joint. So thank you for watching. But this is a subtle thing that many people do in orthodontics do not realize that this happens to them. You need to put the bite plate, but if you put the bite plate and they leave it out, you open the bite up like this, you put a bite plate, they leave it out, this tends to deepen. And if it deepens much, now they close it, and you've got a space like that between your teeth, and nothing hits but the molars. All right, we'll pass that on, and I want to say goodbye and hope you get something out of this routine, this video. If you learn this one thing, it'll be worth your while. Okay, I'm going to stop now.